सो हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ एडवोकेट गौतम अरसवाल, एसोसिएट विद डायलीजी। वेलकम टू डायलीजी। सो वेलकम विद अनदर लीगल टॉपिक। आई एम गोना डिस्कस विद यू अनदर लीगल न्यूज ऑन द सेम चैनल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट डिस्कशन विदाउट एनी डिले। सो द दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट रिसेंटली बेसिक आस्क आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया अबाउट दैट इज मुगल एरा मॉस्क नियर कुतुब मीनार इज ए प्रोटेक्टेड मोन्यूमेंट और नॉट। सो टू दिस वॉट इट हैज़ रिप्लाइड, लेट्स फाइंड आउट इन दिस वीडियो। You know, the Archaeological Survey of India or ASI has been directed to inform the Delhi High Court whether or not a Mughal era mosque situated near Qutub Minar is a protected monument and if prayers can be offered there. So the name of the case is Managing Committee of Delhi Waqf Board versus Union of India and others. In this case, Justice Pratik Jalan was hearing a plea filed by managing committee of the mosque against the authorities' decision to stop people from offering prayers at the mosque. So on the basis of these submissions, so the preliminary submissions advanced by the council for ASI, it appears that the issues to be considered include inter alia whether the mosque is included in the protected area under the notification dated January 24, 1914, and if so, the consequence thereof with regard to permissibility of worship at the mosque stated the order passed on July of 20th. The petitioner committee in this case, appointed by the Delhi Waqf Board, contended that the mosque does not fall within the protected monument as notified by the ASI in a 1914 notification, and that the prayers were being offered there until 13th of May 2022. On that day, the authorities stopped prayer at the mosque without any notice, let alone intimation to the managing committee. So the court noted that the mosque in question was different from the Kutubul Islam mosque in the Qutub Minar complex, which is the subject matter of the suit filed before the Saket district court. After hearing the parties, the bench directed the council for the parties are directed to file the written submissions along with the copies of any authorities upon which they wish to rely within 3 weeks from today. While posting the matter for hearing on October 13, the court also ordered the ASI to produce any available records in relation to the issuance of the 1914 notification. Advocate M. Sufyan Siddiqui, Rakesh Bugra, Kumar Satish Sah, and Alaya Veronica represented the petitioners. That's all about our discussion. I hope you're pretty much clear. See you in the next video with some more information.